Hi, I'm Satchel. I'm the lead guitar player for the most amazing heavy metal band in the world. And I also play guitar in Steel Panther.
You're in Black and Blue?
I am.
That's awesome, dude. I'm Stix Satchel. I play drums in Steel Panther. And I also have a little side jazz fusion Latin project that I'm working on.
Yeah, what's that called?
It's Tom's Trio.
That doesn't sound very Latin.
Tom's half Spanish.
Oh.
He plays the guitar.
I didn't realize that.
He's good. Yeah.
Check that out.
So go check that out.
So I know how difficult it is to get yourself noticed, whether it is as an interviewer, a band, a photographer, but I usually tend to come up with some crazy ideas, because I'm not afraid to do stuff that other people might consider silly or crazy. I just do what I feel like doing, and I usually get other people to join me. Like once I was floating around on a rubber boat at a festival with the name of the band I'm promoting on the side. When you were first starting out as a band, what are some of the things you did to get noticed, and how easy or how hard was it for you to do that?
That is a really good question. There's some,
cool.
I'm probably trillions of bands out there.
I'm not proud of some of the things that I've done to help get Steel Panther off the ground.
I'm proud of everything that I've done.
Really?
Can you give us an example of what you did?
Well, there's been a lot of things, because it's not easy to get noticed in the very beginning.
True.
Well, I dressed as a hot dog, and I walked up and down Sunset Boulevard, and I flyered. This is for the first 6 weeks that we played in, back in the 80s, early 80s.
Oh, yeah.
And all the bands were out there. This is back in the Sunset, you know, Strip day, the heyday. All these hair bands, so it's hard to get noticed when everybody looks good and, you know, sexy like this, and you know, everybody's flyering. So I dress like a hot dog. You'd be amazed at how many girls are afraid of hot dogs. I don't know why that is. Like really big hot dogs. Well, I guess I understand why.
For like a 6 foot hot dog.
Yeah, I guess I can understand why a girl would be afraid of that.
I'd be afraid of a 6 foot hot dog if I was a girl.
I'm not 6 feet, though. A lot of people out there in YouTube land.
But the hot dog can be taller than you.
Oh, well, the hot dog was taller than me.
Yeah.
It was terrifying. I guess your point is well taken.
Thank you.
Because I'm only 5 foot two.
Yeah.
But the hot dog was probably, well over 6 feet. Covered in mustard. You know.
Was there relish on it?
Well, there was a lot of stuff on it. I don't know. It was a rental.
Oh.
Yeah, it was probably some relish.
You didn't get a specific hot dog?
I couldn't afford a new one.
Right. It's better to rent.
No. It was Oscar Mayer.
That's cool.
Yeah, it was a quality hot dog.
I'm not proud of some of the things that I mean, I've done a lot of stuff that I am proud of, but some of the things that I have done, I'm not proud of.
I don't think
of.
That many people found out about Steel Panther when you had sex with a German Shepherd, first of all. So maybe that's why you're not proud of it.
Maybe, yeah, the result is what I'm not proud of.
That's the thing. If it gets the word out.
Yeah. That would have been, it would have been cool. But I guess, you know.
I still think it's cool.
Thanks, dude. You know what? I'm a little more proud of it now. I didn't know that you thought it was cool still.
Well, now you see, that kind of thing matters.
And that comes from a hot dog.
Yeah. That was a hot dog. Trust me.
Oh, yeah.
Nah, she was great. Her name was Sergeant.
Sergeant? It's a sexy name. Sexy dog name.
Who tends to be the one in your band coming up with those crazy ideas?
Who comes up with the crazy ideas?
Yeah.
Oh, we're a crazy idea factory.
Yeah, it's like, you know? It's like, you know what a think tank is?
Yeah.
You know what a brain trust is? It's nothing like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nothing like that. This is more like a clusterfuck. Do you know what that is?
Oh, yeah, that's a technical term.
No, explain.
A clusterfuck is like when everybody starts fucking thinking and, like, you just don't get anywhere. It's just like, you know, shit's running into each other and not working at all. But then all of a sudden, bam! All it takes is one stupid idea. And
like fucking a dog on the Sunset Strip.
With a
Did
hot
dog.
Did
it work?
Right.
Yeah.
With a hot dog.
All of a sudden, you got something. It's like, ooh. We're onto something now.
There's like the wheel and fire, mm-hmm. and then the hot dog suit.
Yeah.
Those are like the three biggest inventions ever.
Oh my god, imagine the first caveman who invented the hot dog. Like, but well, nobody knows who he was, obviously.
His name was Oscar.
Oscar Mayer?
Oscar the caveman.
Oscar the caveman.
Oscar the caveman Mayer. Wow, well, he did a great job.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he really did. I mean,
can't believe he invented the hot dog.
Imagine that. Like, how do you fucking go? Because it's like somebody had to do it.
Right.
Like, you know, they're just living, like, with rocks and killing fucking animals. Mm-hmm. And then it's like, God, this sucks. I have to eat the meat, like, right off the bone. And then just,
they had,
like,
fire, so they're,
bam!
You had to cook something.
I know, but, like, shit, they didn't figure, like, oh, let's cut the meat off. They were eating raw meat, and somebody was like, you guys go ahead and eat the raw meat. I'm going to eat my hot dogs.
Yeah.
They came prepackaged, you know? Isn't that weird how there's, like, only, like, there's 8 hot dogs, but there's only 6 buns, though?
They do that, so you have to buy an extra pack of buns.
Yeah, it sucks. And then you keep going through your whole life, like, 8 dogs, 6 buns, 8 dogs, 6 buns. Okay, now I got fucking 8 dogs and 12 buns.
It's 16 to 12 now. Now it's 32 to 24. It just keeps going.
You just, there's no, there's, those are both prime numbers, so they're impossible to line up.
It's exponential wieners, is what it comes down to. Which
great
is a
prog rock band name.
Oh, yes. Exponential wieners, I love those guys.
We're exponential wieners. We're opening up for Gentle Giant tonight.
That's hot.
Yeah. How much pussy? You'd think they would get a lot of pussy.
Dude, exponential wiener is a lot of pussy.
Too mathematical for most girls.
Yeah.
Sorry, not gonna fuck you. Don't know how many wieners that is. There's gotta be an end to the wiener. Otherwise, you don't know which part to put in.
It's true.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Which side is which?
Yeah, which side is
which?
That's
the album title. Exponential wiener. Which side is a wiener?
Yeah, which side is which? Can't fuck the stumpy side. The stumpy side is a good album.
Song one, two. That's song one and two.
Isn't this amazing? See, is this what you're right?
One question.
It's not a think tank. This is a clusterfuck.
Yes.
Another question. Does it bother you that some people think of you as just a comedy act, or some people think you are too perverted?
Too perverted.
Too perverted.
Oh, wow. I don't know who
if
would
there is
that.
Such a thing.
Fuck that shit in this gaping butthole. We are not perverted.
Yeah.
But does it bother
you
that some people think you are?
You can fucking wipe the shitty sperm right off the dick onto your face if you think that.
Yeah, if you think we're too perverted, suck our flaccid wieners while we're peeing all over your face.
Yeah. I don't know where anybody would get that idea, to be honest with you.
Me neither.
It doesn't bother me what anybody thinks of us because we're so fucking awesome. It's like when you're, you know, it's like asking the Mona Lisa, like, oh, does it bother you that you're not a sculpture and you're just flat on a piece of wood? Oh my god.
She's not that fat.
Not fat. They're flat.
Oh.
Like the Mona Lisa is just a painting. It's not even 3D.
I thought you were asking her why she's fat.
Yeah, it's like saying, gosh, you know, Leonardo da Vinci, you know, are you bummed out that, you know, that you made these sketches of, you know, a flying machine, but it didn't really work? Like, you didn't actually invent the airplane. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you're a pretty good artist and all that. But, you know, you just didn't really invent the airplane. I know you wanted to.
Yeah.
The helicopter or whatever the fuck you. I know you wanted to fly, but, you know, you just didn't pull it off. Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't say that to
that. It's not really with some. I'm sure it doesn't matter to Da Vinci, mainly because he's dead. He's been dead for years.
He's got no feelings now.
Yeah, you don't feel when you're dead.
Or do you?
Have I answered that question? Did you answer the question?
We really don't give a fuck.
We don't give a fuck. That's what I'm trying to say.
That's the answer.
I'm still in clusterfuck mode.
Is there anything that you are afraid of?
Spiders.
Spiders for you?
Poisonous snakes. You know what the taipan is?
No.
Taipan is the deadliest snake known to man. It's in Australia. And you know where it likes to live? Right underneath the rim of toilet seats.
Oh.
And it waits
there.
You know,
do you check every time?
Balls.
Dicks and balls.
You know what I'm afraid of?
You're afraid that the universe isn't really flat, it's curved space, and that eventually, at some point, the space is going to curve, and the universe is going to collapse into itself, and we're going to become a black hole.
That's exactly what I'm afraid
of. Interesting. Yeah.
He nailed it.
Everybody's afraid of that. There's nothing to be ashamed of.
Damn it.
I have a Kanye West question. Did he say anything about the song you guys wrote last month?
No, he didn't say shit.
No,
Kanye didn't say anything because I think Kanye...
Maybe he was jealous.
I think he knows.
Maybe he didn't come up with the idea, so he's jealous.
Well, he'll tell you that he came up with the idea to do a song about himself. Look, the dude knows he's, like, inappropriate. He knows that what he did was douchebaggery.
Douchebaggery at its douchebaggiest.
And so we just put it out and, you know, we just had to call it out.
People responded.
You did the right thing.
Everybody knows, you know, it was... that's the thing about Steel Panther. We speak the truth. You know? We speak the truth.
You're not afraid to speak the truth.
No, we're not afraid to speak the truth. And a lot of people are.
That's what we're not afraid of. If you ask us what we're afraid of, that's one thing we're not afraid of.
Yes.
No, I admire that.
The universe collapsing in on itself. Absolutely. Who would afraid of that? Where the fuck are you going to go? Nowhere to go.
Yeah, it'd freak me out.
Yeah, but, you know, yeah, speaking the truth, no, that's what we fucking do. And Kanye hasn't said anything, but his lack of saying anything has
said
volumes. Right, Kanye? I think we know what you're thinking.
Yeah, I got you.
We're on to you.
We're on to you. We're on to you, na na na. We're on to you, Kanye.
I'm feeling a song coming up.
You know that song?
No.
You don't know that song?
No.
That Hurricane? Who is that?
Hurricane Alice.
Or is it? Who is it? You don't know it.
Giant.
Is it Giant?
No, I don't fucking know. It's a bitch 80s band though.
Yeah.
What song is that? I'm on to you, na 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 na. I'm on to you, Giant? I'm saying Giant. Somebody's gonna YouTube that and write it in the comments.
It's
underneath this video.
Yeah, Hardline.
I'll look it up.
Hardline? Who's the singer of Hardline?
Johnny Gioeli.
Bam! Two guys who know the singer of Hardline.
Who's the guitar player?
Neil Sean. Right?
Boom.
Who's
there
drummer?
You go.
Dean Castronova.
Is it Dean?
Isn't it?
I don't think it is.
No? I think it is.
Is it?
I think it was.
Ooh, it might be.
Do you know who Dean Castronova plays for now?
Journey.
Bam.
What's that?
The fuck was that?
Magic.
Magic.
There's magic all around, people. You just need to reach out and grab it. Oh, shit. I'm not good at that trick.
My head was supposed to disappear.
I was going to pull something from his ear. All I got is a little earwax.
Can you do an edit where you pull something out of my ear?
I can try, yeah.
Right,
I'll
go.
Definitely
Ready?
Try.
Maybe
magic.
We can do a trick where you pull your own head out of your ass for once.
Oh, yeah. Let's do that.
You want to see that.
Not
who's
watch
to
this. Try to edit
it.
This. Okay.
Ta-da.
There you go.
Wait. We're still in clusterfuck, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
How do you feel about any new artists?
I hate them all.
We can't stand new artists.
And do you like any new music?
No, we like new artists.
No, we love all of them, and they're all really great. We'd like to encourage people to...
pick up a guitar.
Yeah, go
Which
out.
Which one do you like in particular?
His name's Alex.
Yeah, I like Alex. Alex is good.
Alex in Texas. He's
super. I'd have
super.
To pick him over Ron.
Totally.
Ron's got some work to do, but Alex is kicking ass.
That's the new artist we like.
Yes. Alex wrote a song the other day.
It's so good.
He only wrote the first fucking three bars, but he's doing good.
You know who I like?
No, tell me.
I like.
That's what she asked a while ago.
I like the Lounge Kittens.
Oh, I like the Lounge Kittens too.
I do. They're really good.
They're really good in bed as well.
Yeah. Yeah. I like them.
They're amazing singers.
Yeah.
Amazing.
And they're sexy singers. Broads.
And they're sexy as well.
Yeah. And who else do I like that's new? Wasp. It's a new
Wasp
band.
Wasp is new. Yeah. I'm Blind in Texas. Blind in Texas, right? That's a good
yes.
song. That's a brand new song. That's a good one.
That's a killer song.
Yep.
And I like Pantera.
That's not a new band.
Pantera's a great new act.
I think they're going to go far. I think they're going to be something.
Yeah. I think so, too. Pretty great. Simon and Garfunkel.
Ooh, they're a good act, too. Have you heard them?
Beautiful.
Yeah, I know that.
They're amazing.
Garfunkel, when you listen to his voice, it's so angelic. And it's like, oh my God, how does an angelic voice... like that have the name Garfunkel.
Yeah, Garfunkel is not a rock and roll name.
Garfunkel.
It's not very rock and roll, right?
Beautiful, like, you know, Bridge Over Troubled Water. You listen to that? Mm-hmm. The whole time you're just singing Garfunkel.
Garfunkel.
It's like having like a hot potato in your mouth.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think the name would be a little like smoother, like, you know, yeah. Think it's a smooth name.
It would have been cool if it was just
Sarsonio or something.
It was Simon and Funk. That would have been cool.
Simon and Funk. No, they would have had to have more drums going on.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Simon and Garçon.
Garçon.
Simon and Garçon. That's cool.
And then he had like a little mustache, a little French.
Oui. Right.
And a beret.
And
yeah.
A beret and a cigarette. And he always did that.
That's who we like.
Yeah. Okay.
Those are the new artists.
This was awesome. Do you have any famous last words for us?
Famous last words?
Well.
Fear not.
The skin of a salamander
will always be at your
peril.
And if you try to
meet in the middle with oneself,
then don't be surprised when
the universe folds
and your cards are shown
to your mother and father at last.
For they will never let you
borrow the car
after 10 p.m.
again.
That was fucking awesome.
I loved it.
Dude,
yeah.
That went places I would never have gone by myself, dude. fucking radical.
That, by the way, just so you know, that was a fucking, what was it called?
Onomatopoeia?
Brain.
Clusterfuck.
Brain fart. Wait.
That's a clusterfuck.
It was a mind wash. Wait, what?
We appreciate you interviewing us.
Yes, thank you.
And I hope that your
hope
viewers...
hope this interview thing goes good for you from now on. I hope this is a launching pad.
I really hope so, too. I have to admit,
be.
I was so nervous doing this because I don't normally do interviews. This is like my second interview.
Well, you are so great.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thanks for having sex with us.
Oh,
we appreciate
again.
That. Yeah, we did it twice. Oh, yeah.